All right. Let's get some music. Fuck me. That was loud. Pardon my language. I'm gonna try to keep this PG-13. What's up, Mark? Up early? Yeah, I get up like around 6 o'clock on the weekends. 5 o'clock on the work days. Alright, just let me know if that music is too loud, yeah? Okay. Hold on, I'm having technical difficulties. Kind of sucks. There we go. What? No. What kind of 60s shit is this? Yeah, you know what? Sorry, everybody. Nothing today. So what do you want me to do? I'm bored to frick. Well, you could build a... You could build something in KSP. Wait a minute. Don't you have a girlfriend? Call her up. Ask her. Say, hey, baby. What you doing? Is it starting? Yes, it's starting. Just let me know if... I was trying to get some music in here, but unfortunately... That's not a thing. Let's try this. Something easy. Something not super loud. Something that won't kill my ears. No, not Grammarly. Help me. Do I have a girlfriend? Yes, you do. You have a girlfriend. Stop hiding her in your pocket. You know, that's not nice. All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen. Here we... If I had, I would tell you. Would you now, Mark? Would you really tell me? But unfortunately, it isn't to be. Not yet, Mark. But good things come to those who wait. Remember that. I mean, look at me. All right, so we've got I've already got the truck all fueled up, got the launch platform ready. Let me know if the music's too loud, by the way. I can fix that. Here we go. Music good for me? Okay, Jay. Let's do this. Let's build this space station. Gosh damn it. The only thing I have to tell, because I don't do shit. Also, I think I should peach if a miracle were to happen. You should preach? If a miracle were to happen, no, keep that Keep that to yourself, bro. We've got like 700 parts on the ground right now, so it's a little laggy. Not gonna lie. I'm actually a little nervous. This will be the maiden, well, not the maiden flight of this particular design, but, you know, this will be the very first time that we've ever really done something like this in a long time. I don't know what to expect. It could explode right here, right now, in which case I'd be like, thank you for joining and goodbye. Alright, let's go ahead and back up into the launch platform. It would help if the brakes were off. I don't have that much fuel left, so I gotta be very careful. Come on. People from the Netherlands. Yes, Mark is from the Netherlands. As we always say, the Netherlands second, right? That's an inside joke, by the way. So I am going to let you guys know that I have not tested this platform, this particular designed, particular platform with a fully fueled rocket on it. This may get crazy. I'm not gonna lie. This may get a little crazy. Ha ha ha, Mark, that's very funny. Hello, Tim, also from the Netherlands. Welcome. Tim Dodd, the everyday astronaut. I know it's really you. Can't hide from me. Come on. All right, we're in position. I sure hope we don't break anything. Here we go. Crap, what button was it again? Okay, this is going to end badly. Number 9. Got to lock it into place. Scratch the paint off, that's okay. All right, we're locked. And up we go. Hold on. Yes, here we go. All right, and down we go. A little bumpy, but I don't have the time or patience to try to make that work. As we all know, the robotics, if you've been watching the videos, The robotics on this game are very weak and cannot hold that kind of tonnage, so I can't have anything that comes down very slowly. Dutch created the Netherlands. Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. It's an awesome machine. It's got kinks in it. But I think she'll be okay. Let's go ahead and open her up and get the first module ready for takeoff. Okay. Darn, I forgot the button for this thing. Which one is it? Is it this one? Yes, okay. Let's see here. I know how to drive. I do it every day. Yep. Yep. Okay. Just, there we go. Okay. No problem. That was graceful. Design is so sick. Well, thank you. I appreciate that. And this thing has brakes. That's why it's not moving. Haha. I figured that out all by myself. At least it's a lot less glitchy than my brakes. Brakes! Aww. I clicked it. Well, at least I wasn't going too fast. All right, let's line up again. Damn it. Good morning, Thumb. How are you this morning? Don't forget, if you like what you see, please leave a like and share it with your friends. Let's beat that YouTube algorithm. That YouTube algorithm never used to be this bad. Oh, don't you dare. I thought it was going to crash on me. I remember when the YouTube algorithm was actually fun and loving and caring. Now it looks at you like... I don't know. I don't think you got what it takes, kid. And it drops you. I don't think you got what it takes, kid. Line her up. Okay. A little further up. Please let this work. You know, to be honest, I haven't really tested this particular design for a loader yet. Ah, the inconsistencies. Is it number 9? Number 9 does it, right? No. Zero? No. 1? Hey, 1! Okay, 1. We're going for 1. Hello, Sea Dragon. It's completely over-engineered. I love it. Yes, the wheel would be very handy in this situation. And why is this not going down like it's supposed to? Either that or it's taking its sweet time. There we go, finally. Good. Goonga Moonga. All right, maybe I will make this go down a little faster. I just didn't think that that would. We'll change it once it's all the way down. I don't want to change both of them, or try to change both of them in mid descent. I guess you could say. Lock that up. And whoop. Nope. Where are you? Oh, there you go. Lock that one. Okay. So I managed to be able to have it so it's got two servos working for the one arm. I know that's very hard for KSP, because KSP does not like to... And where are you going? You are going to connect to the wrong thing, and I'm going to back you up before you do something silly and screw it up for everybody. Okay. Okay. Yeah. No. You're good. Okay. What if the other vehicle runs out of electricity? I sure hope not. I mean, I use the really big batteries for, you know, just for that purpose. Plus, everything's got a nuclear isotope powering it, so we should be good. Just gotta figure out where the hell. I want to say the middle is what I'm going for. Please connect. Please connect. Yay, it's connected. All right. That's F5, because I do not trust anything right now. Okay, quick saved, confirmed. Decouple. And let's change this. Just give it a little bit more. Bring traverse up just a little bit. All right, there we go. Let's try that. Number one. That might be a little too fast. Ooh, Nelly. Whoa. Ha 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 ha. Okay. We will bring those bad boys back down. Good grief. I think that's probably a safe. What game is that? League of Legends. Uh-oh, what's going on? Come on, you can do it. Hello? Oh, I got a control from here. There we go. Okay, now we're cooking with gasoline. Let's do this. Ooh, it's kind of at an angle. Are you going to bump into that? Oh, thank goodness. So I noticed a small problem. It's a little bit of an angle. That is not a good. Hopefully we can make this bad boy work. Are there front wheels? How's the weight distributed? Distribution. How's the weight distribution? Should be okay. We got some back gears and front gears. Most of the weight is on these gears. All the movement power is from... Don't you dare break on me. Please be loving and kind. There we go. Okay, line her up. It's just like operating a forklift. Piece of cake. Oh, gosh. Is it gonna go? Oh, it is gonna go in. Well, shiver me timbers. Nailed it. Well, not yet. We're not out of the woods yet. Easy. 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 Woo-ha-ha. Aim camera. Need to see what the hell I'm looking at. Okay. 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 Do we put Kerbals in here? I think we forgot to put Kerbals in here. Yeah, that's a problem. Okay, F9. Yes. We are going to use the F9 because I don't have any patience whatsoever to try to fix shit. Unless it explodes. If it explodes, then we're screwed. Maybe adding wheels to the module holding thing is a good idea. The module holding thing does have wheels. Look, see? What blew up? What blew up? Oh no. Good morning, my friend. So you're forklift certified? I mean, maybe. Oh boy. Oh my gosh. I made a volcano by accident. What? What? No. Damn you, KSP. Damn you. Okay. Well then. Oh, I screwed the pooch on this one. Wow. Already. Let me think. Jeez. Okay. I know. My God. La la la. Someone's in my hava. I'm going to try something different. I'm going to go to... Holy crap. Space Center. We're going to try to clean it up and just kind of load up those two crafts again. We're not going to use Space Plane Hangar. We're just going to load it from the Space Center. Oh, well, look at that. Okay. So we'll recover that. Cover that. Okay, cool. Where are you? There you are. Hey. Huh? Okay. Okay, let's launch. Wait. Okay, cool. Okay, let's move this out of the way. Let's move this out of the way. It's fully fueled, okay? And it was empty when I loaded it, and we fueled it up already, and we drove all the way back, so I don't want to do that again. So if you're new here and you like what you see, I hope you can hit that like button for me so we can fight the YouTube algorithm together. It really helps me out. And thank you so much for being here. This thing weighs about 2 billion tons. It's very breakable. It's so breakable. In fact, I think I'll go safe. The safe way and just kind of very gently. I'll just very gently move off the runway. At a very slow pace. Very, hey, no slideys. No, even, you're not cock, oh, awesome. Okay, that's Vaos talk. I'm so sorry. Sometimes it comes out. There we go. How much does this thing weigh? Probably about a lot of tons. I mean, it's fully fueled. It's fully fueled. Fully fueled. So, Yeah. We're serious tonnage right now. Okay, so the weight of the craft is actually being distributed by the landing gears, because landing gears, for some reason, don't pop under extreme rate, which is like weight. No, it's not. And basically, most of the weight is on the landing gears, and then these, you know, as every experienced KSP player knows, they're made out of tin foil and will pop very easily under a lot of weight. So we want to make sure all the weight's on the gears and not the wheels, but the wheels will give us ability to drive around. Let's go to space plane, space center. There we go. For those of you who stick to the very end of this stream, I have a little special something for you. A little sneak peek about a video I'm coming out with. I'm going to start making videos that are like my old ones. You know, the ones that had my channel take off like a rocket before I started doing other ones that made everything slow down to barely anything. But they were the build with me kind of videos. So basically, I record myself for about 2 hours building a craft. Then I put it in edit, take out all the boring bits, and after about 10 or 11 minutes, go from nothing to something, and you can kind of follow along. Okay, retract. So why do I have this big, giant landing gear for this thing right here? Well, that's because when it comes down, it kind of touches down a little hard heavy. So it's nice to be able to touch down when the nose is still up, instead of having the back wheels hit and the nose to slam down. Nose to slam down forwards. It kind of messes things up a little bit. Number one. Two. Duh. All right, let's move this out of the way. Gonna get some coffee once. I haven't drank coffee in eons. But no, thank you, but thank you. It's very lovely, very lovely, very sweet of you, yes. Howdy. What's going on, exploding cake? Which I've always thought of. Would I eat exploding cake, or would I wait for it to explode, then eat it? Try space center. Okay. Okay, let's do this again. Coffee is meh. Well, Mark, you're like... I don't, if it wasn't for the fact that I know better, people would think you're an alcoholic. If it wasn't for the fact that I know better, people would think that you're an alcoholic. You need to lay off the gin, my bro. Try water. It's so much more refreshing. Shoot, which one was it? Ah, LP, launch platform. 75 parts, okay. Is this the updated one? Oh, I sure hope that's the updated one. He's like, shush. I drink coffee and alcohol. Life is good. Explosions give the cake a rich gunpowder flavor aftertaste. Yeah, sure, okay. Okay, now we want a vid of Vaos eating an exploding cake. Good gosh. I mean, I know how to make one. Maybe take exploding cake out of the coffee first. Okay, let's F5 save this bad boy. Cannot quick save while shit's moving. Stuff's moving. Sorry, I am trying so hard not to swear. If you've noticed, this stream is monetized. F5? Yes, ever since I started monetizing my videos about a month ago, I have made a whopping $2.88. Whoo! I can finally get that drink I've always wanted from the machine. Okay. It's F5 one more time. Note to self, never, ever F9 while the craft is in the launch platform. So yay me. you're beginning the long construction process. Well, I mean, we've ran into a couple of problems already, but I think we're gonna work through them fairly quickly. Hey, Papa. Hey. How are you? Maybe just do a minimal save. Go away, system mechanic. We don't want you right now. Minimal save, just to be safe. Yeah, I saved already. Matter of fact, I think I'll save one more time when the craft is backed up into its spot. Spot. Come on. There we go. You're in Williamsburg? Truck maintenance? Truck maintenance. Is everything okay with the truck? Routine. Oh, okay. Because it's a very lovely truck. I would hate for it to for something to be wrong with it already. Don't blow up. Look, I drive trucks for a living. Gosh dang it. I could back this sucker into a tight little pint-sized hole and not still be screw it. And brakes. Perfection. Okay, so what we're gonna do is I don't even think I should save it like this, to be honest. I think it would blow up even with something above it. KSP is finicky as it is, does not like it when vehicles are this close together without being connected. So that being said, anything that goes now, we cannot save. Cannot save. Okay, sounds like a plan. Meet up on Sunday on breakfast. Yeah. Sounds like a plan. This beauty is so sexy. Well, thank you. It's something that NASA should have done a long time. You know what? I'm not even going to go there. Stepping off my soapbox. Number 9. Squeegee in here. There we go. Locked. And lifting up. Whoa. Whoa, easy. Easy. Nice. And easy. I mean, Elon's doing good with Starship. I can't wait for Starship 11 to do its thing. That will be awesome. I want it to actually stick the landing this time. And just sit there with all of its glory shining. Instead of, you know, 5 minutes later saying, okay, I'm out. I did what I did. Peace. Boom. All right, we cannot save. We cannot save. Let's go ahead and grab our Kerbals. Hello? What? Oh. Okay, we're going to transfer our Kerbals over here. I think what we'll do... Ooh. I think what we'll do is only put one... we'll put two Kerbals in here. And then Valentina will come up on the next mission. One of these, right? That's probably better. I like driving like I like. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. All right, no saving. The couple node. All right, let's do this again. Oh, what was it? Didn't we screw this up? Yeah. Okay. Let's make it traverse up to 12, so it doesn't take too long. But at the same time, doesn't kick. Oh, okay. Well, it did to both of them. Sweet. It doesn't catapult the whole darn thing into the air. And here we go. Number one. Yep, number one. I hit the button and we are just waiting. There it goes. Okay, I'll talk to you later too. My gosh, that was a little harder than I wanted. Nuts in a barrel. Turning around. Or at least we're trying to. Attempting to turn around. Oh, that's because we have the wrong thing control from here. Wait. 1 second. Give me 1 second. Something came up. Ah, crap. Having technical difficulties. Alright, let's try this again. Is it working? Yeah! Whoa, hey. Hey now. Hey. Back up, back the hell up. Ah. Okay, we're good. Just gotta be very careful with this thing. She's slightly temperamental. Hello, I don't know who you are, but I'm gonna sub. Well, thank you, spaceman. I appreciate your sub. Anybody who's new to this stream or channel, I would greatly love it if I earned your like today. That'd be nice. You can help me fight the YouTube algorithm. Wow. I have politics on the brain, obviously. Every like helps a lot. Thank you so much. Is using engine to actuate thing is out of tape. What? Is using engine to actuate thing is out of table right? Maybe? Possibly? I know how to play KSP, but I don't have it sad right now. Oh, you don't have it right now? You know how to play it, but you don't have it? Okay. Well, don't worry. Good things come to those who wait. And I'm just waiting for this thing to actually turn. Yay. I'm getting a lot of tearing. I'm not sure if that's my aging graphics card or just the brand new KSP that came out 1.1.1.1.1.1.1. It might be slightly buggy. In which case, we're all gonna die. Well, I did, in one of my videos, I did talk about that using a jet engine or a rocket engine instead of the motors. And the thing is, I'm trying to kind of copy realism here. So in realistic terms, they would never put a jet engine or a motor on a mechanical mobile platform, because of the fact that things that run off of fuel tend to explode. So what I mean by that is, you know, like a jet engine or a rocket, obviously. So a lot of what they would do in real life is that they would... Oh my gosh. Did I hit something? Oh no! It's not tall enough! Oh. Oh dear. Oh no. Oh no! Oh, that's not tall enough either. Oh, that's bad. Oh no. Oh no. Okay, we have a real problem now. I can't get in. Oh my gosh. Ooh. Ooh. So, as I was saying, trying to keep things mechanical, because mechanical is more reliable than a jet engine or a rocket that would explode. And, yeah, I'm trying to wrap my head around this very serious problem. Oh my gosh, really? Oh, man. Okay, let me think. There's a way to do this. I know there is. Okay, so I'm going to come back down here. Alright, I'm going to come back down here and, Where are you? Give me. There you are. Okay, we're going to make this all the way down. My idea is to let go of it and then sort of push it in as I lower down. That's a really bad idea, but we're just going to do it. Okay, disarm. Okay. And number one. Come on. Oh, please. Push down. Go down. Any time now. Any day now would be great. Yes? No? Are they even on? Is it working? Oh, boy. Yeah, they're all the way. Oh, there it goes, finally. Oh, this is really bad. Come on. No, 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 don't let it fall out! Save the kerbals! Full power, Scotty! Push it back in! Save the kerbals! Oh my gosh! Oh, come on! Oh, hook up already. Oh, come on. Don't blow up. Don't blow up. And is it in? 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 No. Crap. Oh. Unbelievable. Oh, wait, 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 wait. It's about to go in. Yes! Aha! Okay! Wow. That was not good at all. So the design flaw came from this being way too low to the ground, which means I need to lift this up at least a few inches so that this thing can roll underneath. Once it rolls underneath, then we'll be good. Hello, Inter! How are you? By the way, what are you making? A reusable SSRT to build a space station without using spaceplane hangar or the VAB. But we have a serious glitch. Or not glitch, but a slight problem. And that is this thing right here needs to be updated just a little bit. I see, but since in-game motor doesn't reflect real life, wouldn't a little bit of compromise? Compromise? Yeah, but as long as we don't have to use jet engines or rockets to actually move things up and down, that could be easily designed for a mechanical. If we can make something that's mechanical that moves up and down, then we don't need to use the jets or the rockets, because using jets or rockets, in my opinion, is the extremely easy way out. So it's more fun if we discover how to make it mechanical, work mechanically. Because once you discover how to make it work mechanically, not only do you have a reliable system, but it's that sense of accomplishment. Okay, so now we need to fuel up. Just a little bit. There we go. Close the door. It'll dock on liftoff. I wouldn't worry about it. Yeah, it'll dock on liftoff, right through the back end of that thing. Evening, James. All right, let's do this. So what I'll do is, when this thing is in space, I'll just, I'm gonna have to break my rule for 2 seconds and just fix that problem with the height of the launch pad. I'll have to go into space plane hangar and just lift it up ever so slightly. Just lift everything up. Minor setback. Okay, so the next thing we're going to want to bring up there is, of course, the space tug, so that the rest of the modules can be equipped onto the space station. Back up, back up, back up. All right, we're lined up. Let's go ahead and fuel this bad boy up. Ah, come on. Hello, there we go. I blame you, Mark. YouTube specific icons for opportunity to use them. What's the full meaning of SSRT? Well, I did put it in the description below the video. However, SSRT does stand for single staged rocket technology. It was the terminology that was used before SSTO was used back in the 50s. Or 60s, late 60s? I don't know. It says sing stage. Are you shitting? Excuse me, language. Are you kidding me? Oh no! Oh no! Oh, I did it bad. Oh no! Oh no! Oh crap! I did it bad. See how easy these things pop? It's redonkulous, man. You would think that these things were even more stronger than landing gears, but. That's a no. That's a negative, partner. Alright, we only popped two. We've got plenty more. I think what we'll do is we'll get a Kerbal out here to help. Come on, get. Don't slide back down. Oh, come on. Get up there. Oh, get up there. Please get up there. Oh, we got problems. we got some problems. Oh, she's sliding. She's sliding. Yeah. Okay. Let's back it up. Back it up. Back it up. Back it up. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh, she's so heavy. Oh, this is bad. What? 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 Oh, oh, no. We broke another one. I think we have an engineer. No, we have a pilot. Son of a biscuit. I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm fine. I'm just fine. Who's this? Who's an engineer? Oh, do something already. Wake up. Engineer, okay. Scientist. And the door is going to be blocked because it's not pointing the right way. Did you see using space shuttle to go to the moon in for all mankind? Is that possible? Not only is it not possible, but it's not really realistic. I mean, it's... I shouldn't say not possible. It could be possible if you were to turn the cargo bay into a big giant fuel tank. Maybe then you'll have enough delta V to get to the moon. I'm not sure about coming back. But can you imagine coming back? I mean, you're coming back. You're going a lot faster than you were orbiting the Earth. Right? The Apollo heat shield was meant for that kind of thing. I'm not sure, unless they like made the heat shield thicker on the space shuttle, if it would be able to take that kind of slap into the atmosphere. It's possible, but damn, they'd have to make that heat shield a lot thicker. Because as we all know, the heat shield on the space shuttle was like an inch thick, made out of super glued tiles that tend to come off periodically. So, yeah. Cool concept, but not really feasible. SpaceX, on the other hand, has a good idea. Really good idea. Easy on fuel, more realistic, and not as expensive. Because as we all know, the space shuttle was just a horrible, money-guzzling beast. They say, oh, it was completely reusable. Actually, not really. When it came back on the ground, they had to refurbish every inch of it. They basically rebuilt it every time. Kind of a setback. And I'm trying to figure out... heck. Jebediah, can he fix stuff too? No, they're both pilots. Son of a biscuit. We need an engineer to fix our... Oh, man, this sucks. We need an engineer. It takes a shot. The rocket will never launch. The rocket's not going to launch if I can't get the fuel to it. Shuttle version 2. Is that some sort of Hollywood made-up shuttle? You need repair kits to do... What? No, Winter! Don't tell me that! Hence why I'm boycotting 111. Oh, are you kidding me? I have to have repair kits to repair stuff? I did not know that. Son of a biscuit eater. The only other shuttle that I remember NASA coming up or thinking about coming up with was called Venture Star. It was going to be the first SSRT ever made. It was going to be awesome. It was going to be fuel efficient, super fast turnaround time, blah, 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 blah. This thing is kind of based on the Venture Star. I had a lot of great hopes for Venture Star. But I think SpaceX is going to take the lead on that. They're doing things really well, so. All right, so I'm going to speed up with what little wheels that we have, and hopefully enough speed I can just lop right up in there. Yeah, maybe somebody from the building. That'd be nice if you could summon Kerbals out the front door of the buildings, but nay. Get up there right now. Don't you dare spin out of control. Get your ass up there right now. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, this mission is saved. Ooh, we popped more wheels. This mission is saved. If we can get this sucker into space... then we can get some engineers on the ground and redo the launch platform. There was Shuttle Block 2 concept with abort system, boosters, and some other improvements. I don't remember. Yeah, me neither. I don't remember them. Maybe it was like a concept and it just kind of fell to the wayside when they canceled the whole shuttle project because of the gallons of dollars that that thing was sucking up. Well, I wasn't trying to go for the Venture Star, to be honest. I mean, it was inspired by a Venture Star-ish kind of thing. But, I was going for a... I was going for, to be honest, what really inspired this was a combination of the Venture Star, but also a 1950s sketch of what the shuttle, what they were going to make the shuttle, right? They were going to make the shuttle this large space plane with like three or four rockets in the back of it. And then they're just going to have the space plane with fuel tanks on top of it, on top of the nose. So the space plane was going to have fuel tanks on top of the nose, and then it was going to, under its own power, it's all the engines would be on the space shuttle. It was going to fly up as far as possible and then detach the side fuel tanks, right? And then it was going to keep on going because it had a fuel tank on the shuttle itself that would just keep on going right into orbit. To be honest, I think that that would probably have been the better, because of the fact that you don't have to waste, you know, a whole bunch of resources. It's just two tanks. You just dump the tanks, right? And back then, NASA was all about dumping parts into the ocean anyway. Usability was not a thing. All right, here we go. Is a bad news for space planes. I mean, there's still space plane concepts. It's not over yet, right? So maybe the shuttle specs are different than reality. Yeah, I'm gonna have to agree with you on that. Okay, we're gonna lock this bad boy up, and everybody cross their fingers. If this explodes, then I have no backups. This will be a very short stream. Okay, here we go. Let's begin the fueling process ever so gently. 1 meter per second. Hold up before contact. I want to go ahead and lock this. Yes, okay, locked. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. Wow, that's a lot of lights. More than I anticipated. Nice and easy. What? Okay. Easy. Ooh. Okay. Easy. Easy. Almost there. Almost there. Come on. And contact. Anybody dying? Stuff blowing up? No? We good? We good? We all good? Anything shaking? Alright, good. Whew. Okay, let's not touch anything that we're not supposed to. Okay. Let's fuel up the middle first, and then the sides. All right, there's the middle. There we go. Make sure we get everything. Now this is a light payload, so I'm thinking not so much fuel. It's a fairly light payload. This thing can haul 36 tons into orbit. It's designed to haul 36 tons into, hey, don't you dare glitch on me, into orbit. So we'll be a lot careful. All right. Yeah, space plane concept is not over. Even Starship looks like a space plane. Yeah, sort of ish. Remember to demonetize the piston. Oh, do what? Demotorize the piston. So no slidey. Yeah, I got it locked, so it shouldn't slide, hopefully. Oh dear, he locked it exactly the opposite of what I would have done. When he read my comment, it'll be launched. It will be launch time, yeah. Exactly. Sorry. Thank you everyone for joining, by the way. I'm gonna periodically just blurt this out. If you like what you see, please hit the like. Okay, I want to hit the fast forward button, but I'm terrified. I'm so terrified. Do you think it's safe to hit the fast forward button? You know how things like to boggle around and break. Ooh, should we hit the fast forward button? I don't know. I'm gonna say no. Just no. Screw it. Please don't kill me. Here we go. And undo. Well, a little bouncy. And we're good. Hey. Nice. Demonetized pistons, no money for you. Yeah, there's no railgun's ability. You can't really do that in KSP. I mean, don't get me wrong, I've done something similar to it. I've made a row of wheels, right? A row of wheels on a rail, and then I've thrown like a projectile through those wheels so that the wheels spun so fast that the projectile literally kind of went through the wheels and then got spit out the other end, but it never really achieved anything remarkable. So, yeah. All right, so the tanks in the middle are done. Let's get the side tanks all figured out. Clicky. Okay. Now, again, I don't think I'm going to fill them up completely because it's a very light load. That's not a railgun, that's a Nerf gun. Yeah, bring back memories. All right, fast forward. I'm just gonna do a little bit. No, we can go a little faster. There we go. A little faster. Yeah. Okay, slow down. Slow down. Almost there, and good. Don't blow up. Don't blow up. Don't blow up. Don't be suspicious. Don't be suspicious. All right, so this is telling me I've got a lot of. You know what? Screw it. We'll fill it up. We'll fill it up. Well, not completely, but you know. We'll give it most of the gas. I like the fact that you can fast forward and it's not blowing up. That's a plus in my book. Really? That filled it up? Huh. Okay. It's fully fueled. My, my, my. All right, she's fully fueled. Let's hope that she doesn't blow up when we disconnect. That would really, really suck. Release. And disarm. Now back the hell up. Back up faster. All right. You know, I'm wondering if during like SpaceX launches and stuff, when they're refueling the rocket and whatnot, if this kind of tension is real in the control room, right? Like everybody's like every second, every time they hook up the fuel, every time the fuel pumps are going, all of this stuff is just, you know, they're just biting their fingernails. I can imagine they're just sitting there biting their fingernails like, please don't explode, please don't explode. All right, we're getting ready to launch. She's fueled up. She's got payload inside of her. Everything's ready to go. Checking systems. Check, check, check. All systems check. F5, F5. You can't save. I cannot save while this thing is on the launch pad. Because if I try to reload it, the whole thing explodes. Just check back like 10 minutes in. Alright, okay. Okay. We've got two Kerbals on board. All systems look like they're good. I want to see what this kind of looks like. That's so cool. They're all sitting inside. They're all comfy. Fuel's over there. Getting ready to go into space. Locking her up. Are you all ready back there? Good. Check, check, check. Let's make sure we're controlling this from the right control panel, which would be this one. So control from here. There we go. She's all orientated. The fear is real. Light that candle. Okay, we're going to light this candle. Okay, let me make sure I've got a SAS on. RCS is good. Engines online. Mamacita, please don't explode. Okay. Engines good. Launching in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ignition. Oh, little bump. We're good. Launch is successful. Sweet, sweet, sweet. Okay, if I can remember how to fly this thing, then we'll be okay. Oh, ha ha, hee ho. All right. Let me think. What was it? At 100? Tilt to 90 degrees. Tower clear. Yep. All right. Now we're going to go ahead and tilt down. Get ready for our gravity turn. All right. She's in her gravity turn. Hopefully not. Hopefully I didn't turn it too early. A little awesome. Okay, there she goes. We're good. Heading's good. Delta V looks good. Fuel, good. Electric charge, good. Try to get a better orbit here. Come on. Oh, hey. Easy. Easy, girl. Easy. Just trying to get you orientated. That's all. That's all. Nice and easy. All right. So we're a little lower than what I want at this stage. I'm going to go ahead and straighten her out. We're going to kind of defy our gravity turn here until we're past a certain point. Hopefully that doesn't make it too nose heavy from the angle of attack compared to where we're moving. And come on baby. Okay, there we go. Looking good. So we are using the vector engines, space shuttle engines. They're the best in the game when it comes to something like this. Straighten out again. Apoapsis height is almost at 80, and we'll stop right there. And we'll coast the rest of the way. Not sure what else. Have I been on here 76 minutes already? Yeah. We started at 9 o'clock. It's already 10:19. Little fingertip wave. You can save now. Yes, I can. F5. Good thinking. I mean, we're in space, pretty much. All it is now is just a burn into orbit. We've got plenty of delta V, so we're not hurting. Fast forward a little bit. All right, about 20 seconds out, full burn. Keep an eye on the time to apoapsis. Okay, it's climbing, so I'm going to bring our throttle down. Let it go down to about 10 seconds before I throttle back up. Alright, throttle up. Let it slow down a little bit. 9 seconds to apoapsis. It's climbing back up, so I'm going to throttle down a little bit. It's going back down. Let's go. It's climbing up. Throttle down. It's climbing up. Throttle down some more. Oh, speed up. Go down. Yeah. Ooh. Alright, screw it. We're pretty much there. And bingo! Right around 80,000. Okay, we're in orbit around Kerbin. Orbit achieved. Let's whip around the other side real quick. Get a nice lighting effect here. So there's not really much, if any, reaction wheels whatsoever. Everything is controlled via RCS, just like in real life. Nice. Very nice. Why, thank you. Sighs of relief, yeah. That's right, Eastern Standard Time over here. Well then, YF you, or Strats, you should... you should be studying. What the hell are you doing? Okay, so we're a little crooked, but that's okay, because the station has the ability to adjust itself. But I just needed the light. Alright, let's go ahead and open those doors up while the Kerbals are in their little seats. So that'd be cool. Huh, where'd the runway go? It's space! We're in space! Dude, we're in and we're tilting. Why are we tilting? Oh, you're using your shit. I mean, stuff. Excuse me. Bad language. Mean. Bad. Should have turned those off. Okay, we already ate through a lot of our monopropellant. Let's do this. Oh, no, wrong button. Okay, calm down. Hands off keyboard. We're no longer in orbit. Damn, boy, he thick. We're not in Kansas anymore. How does satellite control its heading? What is the ratio RCS reaction wheel? I mean, I have no idea. I'm not an engineer. Hello, how are you? Easy. Whoa. Okay. All we're trying to do is get it back into orbit. Very carefully. And a little bit of engine power here. Okay, we're back in orbit. Sort of. There we go. Let's turn those engines off, shall we? Good. Goonga Moonga. Let's try this again. Are you still now? Am I gonna get any problems from you? Okay, good. Alright, let's go ahead and disconnect as fast as we can. Oh, wait. We'll make sure the batteries are good first before we do this. What's the batteries look like? Check. Good. Alright. And as a rule of it, I never activate RCS until I'm ready. Yes. He's not an engineer. I'm not an engineer. I really am not. I'm what you call a backyard engineer. Does that make sense? I have to disable it from the other one. There we go. Undock. All right, she's undocked. So what I'll do is I'll actually move the shuttle out of the way, or the SSRT out of the way. Here we go. All right, we are free. Free as a bird, ladies and gentlemen. First core space station part is in space with a crew of two. Let's go ahead and get this thing ready. I don't know. Can you open the doors on this thing? Is that even a possible? Oh, it better be possible because I kind of put everything in there. Open doors. All right. Now, because it's the core, it doesn't have everything. It just has enough. Enough to get started. It's got batteries. It's got power. It's got heat. It's got communications. It's just enough. And whoa, she's kind of warmed up there. No, get it right, Vaos. Huh? Has no no operational SAS modules and no pilots aboard. Cannot engage SAS. Oh, well, that might be a problem. Oh dear. Okay, that's a new problem. So that means that I'm gonna have to, I'm gonna have to be very gentle. Okay, so this is going to have to be... man. You know what? The tow truck has SAS on it. So when we bring the tow vehicle up there, we should be good. Okay, our first space station part is in space. But before we land this beauty, we're going to go back to the space... We're going to F5 first. We're going back to the space plane hangar. Batteries, power, heat. Oh, okay. Oh yeah, we're going to add a couple more modules before we're done. Let's go to the Space Center. Now, I know I'm going to break my own rule for doing this, but we have to because I don't feel like loading up everything the same way we just loaded up those poor Kerbals. Yeah, the shadow of the payload on the rock was pretty cool. Send help. All right, so we're going to recover this. And, you know what? Let's recover the, gosh, damn it. No, we don't have to recover that. We'll just... We're gonna move it out of the way and have a team of specialists repair it. Hello, how are you? That's where scientists live. Sending help. Okay, so this poor thing has broken tires left and right. Does anybody know how many of these repair packs I need in order to repair something? Which, by the way, I don't think I'm ever going to make this thing go off the runway ever again. I'm just going to bite the bullet and drive up here and park it. Explode the power of 10 dying suns. Okay, she's out of the way, but she's kind of hurt. We're going to have to make like a engineering team. I was kind of hoping to avoid that, but we're going to have to do it any way. So let's go space center. Huh. A bit dizzy. Oh, you poor guy. I don't know, one repair pack? We're about to find out. I know, sometimes you just gotta do it though, man. The math, the history, everything, just gotta do it. Would Mark go to bed? It's like 6 o'clock over there, isn't it? Your voice, like the existential dread. Vaos is about to discover the pain and horror of KSP. Repair kits. Oh, gosh. Okay, so we just need a repair truck. We're gonna do this real quick. We need an engineering truck. We need a repair truck. Wonderful that I figured all this out in the middle of stream. Okay, not too big, right? Don't need anything too brainstormy here. Okay, that's not gonna work. Something very simple. Okay. I mean, it looks kind of cool, but it's not going to work, is it? Can this hold stuff? Oh, it doesn't hold a whole lot of stuff, does it? Yowzers. Hold on. Let's try something else here. Don't we have, like, containers now? Yes, we do. Proper times. Right. Okay. All right. It's kind of. How much can I fit in there? Only 3. Oh, we're gonna need a lot more than that. If we're gonna be having tires breaking left and right, we're gonna need a lot more than that. I mean, that's cute, right? Looks like almost like a missile launcher back here. Let's bring this down a little bit to Kerbal level. Okay. Oh, we can bring them out too. Okay, okay. And let's go ahead and let's make sure that this thing has what it needs. Something to generate electricity. A little engine right here. Some fuel. Doesn't need a whole lot. Ooh, those don't look... There we go. Put some fuel right there. Give it the gas. And of course, make sure she's got battery to drive around. Okay. She's got gas tank on one side, a little close to the wheel though. Let's do that, all right. Gas tank on one side, battery on the other, engine in front. And Kerbals, we need Kerbals. We need an engineer. Let's go to Astronaut Complex, and we need some engineers. There we go. We got plenty of pilots. I'm not too worried about that. There we go. Full crew of engineers. No, screw it. Let's put a pilot in here. Oh, wait. No, we're good. Okay, good. Three engineers. Good. And don't forget a mountain of stuff. I'll be lurking. Best of luck to you, my dude. All right, see you later, buddy. This is a car, totally. Containers along the side to make it easier to get to. Repair the vehicle by shooting the repair kit at it. Really? Damn, it looks so cool, too. I kind of like this truck thing back here. I figured they just go up and take what they need and come back down. Alright. You know what? Because I'm just sick for aesthetically pleasing stuff. Yeah, put a little antennas on the back. All right, and lights, of course. Got to put lights on it, right? It's a vehicle, after all. Okay, cool. Cool. Oh, wait. No, this is a repair truck. What am I doing? Let's do this. I love how KSP gives you colored stuff but doesn't actually copy it over. There we go. We got our amber caution warning lights. We're good, baby. All right, amber caution warning lights. Look at this. Ah, boy. Kissless Cybertruck. KSP edition. Only be seeing out the top of the window. I know, right? I mean, I guess we could change that. I mean, I just like the way this looks. But you are right. If we're going to go as far as putting, you know, lights all over the place, then we got to at least give it a... We got to at least give it a somewhat of a nice cockpit. Ew. It was looking good before I started messing around with the... Oh, here we go. Wait. Don't we have that new piece? Ooh. Damn, I could have gone just like that. Oh no. Oh, did I goof? Oh, I goofed hard, didn't I? Oh, I goofed hard. Oh, mamacita. Oh, please forgive me. Oh, wait, we can still make this work. Sort of. Yee. Oh, the cringe. Oh, the cringe. Oh, come on. Please work for me? Oh, sort of kind of works. Sort of. Not quite. Sort of kind of works. Just a little bit. Here we go. Yeah, see? That kind of works. Right? Oh, duh. No, the lights. Well, at least we can kind of do this, right? There we go. Yeah. Okay. Oh, I need one more thing. See, I hate doing this because then I start getting detailed. And when that happens... Too small. All right. Okay. Yeah, we're good. Oh, we're so good right now. Holy crap. Nice. Really nice. Okay, it's something, right? Let's go ahead and what do you call it? Oh, da 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 da. Yes. Yeah. Hopefully it doesn't bounce around. That's my fear, that's going to kind of bounce around a little bit. All right, I think you can take Kerbals out of there? I'm not sure. Let's go ahead and put stuff in here. Repair kits, right? Just repair kits out the yin yang. So many repair kits. All the repair kits. By the way, what's this experiment kit? Okay. Just want to make sure it wasn't like medical. Should be good, right? Lights? Should we put a light out there just in case? Nah, we're good. Yeah. We got helmet lights. We're fine. Oh, what did I do wrong? I think I did something wrong. Oh, no, I didn't. Cool. Okay, come on with the... La, 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 la. You want some too? Fine. I'll give you some too. Oh, come on, some of them! I got some. So I've noticed that I've lost my amber lights, and they went back to white again. That's a common occurrence in KSP 1111111. Some serious problems there. Find Vaos putting on a Las Vegas light show. Cringe patented repair truck. All right. Okay, I think we're good. We got plenty of people. No, I didn't think so. All right, engineers all there. Okay. Okay, cool. Cool beans. One more thing I want to do. Just move this tire up slightly. There we go. All right, looks good. Move this tire up a little bit. There we go. Like that, key. Yeah. Looking good, looking good. And here we... Oh wait, repair truck, RT1. Alright, we got a repair truck. Cool. So now we want to save that. Open. And we just want to fix this real quick, because last time it was a real pain in the butt to try to load stuff up. And I saw that it hit something too on the way out. So I'm thinking this is a little in the way. Alright. And I want to bring these up just a pinch. And of course, we're going to coincide that with this. Okay. Gulp. Bring that up just a little bit there. Okay. All right. Okay. 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 A little bit of a thing on the fly, but I think we're good. Make sure they're in there. No, they are not. They keep on jumping out. You little craps, get back in there. Save and launch. Mr. Mark, well, I'm off. See you all faces later. All right, Mark. You can fit 4 repair kits per slot. Notice the green vertical bars.
No! Into why?
You know what? Screw it. We got a lot of repair kits on there already. I don't think we're gonna pop that many tires anymore. What? Come on, KSP. What's going on, man? Why can't you keep your colors? Huh? Eh? Why can't you keep your colors, yeah? Looking good. Plenty of fuel. Damn, she can kind of go kind of fast. Alright, alright. Easy with the speed. Let's go ahead and do some repairs real quick. Stop would be great. Thank you. Engineering truck to the rescue. She has a nice looking truck. I mean, I have to admit, I think I did a great job for like 2 seconds worth of play. Why do you have... Can I throw this away? All right, hold up. This is kind of new to me. Right, and I'll put this on you. Hey, looky, looky. Okay, we can put more on there, right? Oh my gosh, look at this. This is great. Okay, she's gonna have a lot of them. She's gonna what? Okay. All right, she's gonna have a total of. Oh no, my AC kicked in. I can't hear shit. She's gonna have a total of 8 repair packs. Chef's gotta look good. Give him his amber lights. Stack repair kits. Yeah, I found that out a little late. I love how they have like a little baggie. Almost reminds me of like, you know, the freaking okay, how's this gonna work? So I guess I click this repair kits required. I need 4 repair kits to fix a giant tire. Damn, we're gonna run out of repair kits quick. Son of a biscuit. All right, let's go ahead and repair it. Crew member has insufficient... What? You're an engineer, right? You're a pilot. Mutt, get your pilot butt back up in there. I thought you were an engineer. I am ashamed of you. Get back up in there. Get back. She's like, get up in there. Whoops. Sorry. Okay, F, no. Climb up. Climb out. There we go. You disappointed me. Well, I'm... What? Is there a way to hold down... Do I have to hold down shift to grab all of them? How do you grab all of them at once? Or can you? Is that not a thing? I guess it's not a thing. Good grief. I've never done this before, so I'm learning. Yeah, I understand stacking now. Imagine if it was just 15 storage units. Yeah. Wait, don't just board her. I think you need to take all the crap out of the inventory first. You know what? Let's do one better. We're gonna run out of repair kits very quickly. Let's go back to the hangar bay. I know I said I wasn't gonna use hangar stuff. This kind of sucks. There it goes, taking the color out of my damn things again. Come on, KSP. Stop being a dick. You are no longer allowed to be in there. Yeah, because I put you in the lander can, so why the heck would you pop out? Oh, unless you came out from here. Oh. So that means I need to scoot this back a little bit more. There we go. I think. Maybe. Okay. Alright, okay. Wait, how do you get rid of stuff? Oh, okay. This is gonna be long and painful. All right. Is there a way to do this a lot faster without having to individually click this stuff? Shit. No, go back. Oh wait, did I hit? I hit Alt. Okay, that didn't work at all. Why is it giving me 4 all of a sudden? Okay, well that's very weird, but I'll take it. I'm hitting Alt while I'm doing this, and it's giving me 4. It's weird. I mean, it's nice. Bump, bump, bump. Done. Okay, so I hit Alt and it did that for me. Same thing with this. And she's a pilot. She doesn't need that in her inventory. Okay. And of course it's going to erase the damn lights for me anyway. Watch, I'll make this yellow and it's going to be white when I get out here. Add a canopy in the back. You want that canopy really badly, don't you?
You can taste it.
I took some kits out of storage. I wasn't going to say anything. No, I didn't take any kits out of storage. You see, I got plenty in storage. Look at all those wonderful kits. Oh, no! We're missing a kit! Why me? And look, it changed it to... It does not like colors. These lights, they don't like colors at all. It's very good that the KSP developers allowed you to change colors on demand up here, because that kind of sucks, you know? Wait. Thank you. Okay, we should have what we need right now. We should have everything. They need protection from the rain. There's no clouds on the entire planet of KSP. Okay. It never made any sense, and I've contacted the developers of KSP, and I've just gotten the cold shoulder there every time. I'm not their favorite channel. I really think that the KSP developers do not like me at all. They'll go for Matt Lone way before they go for me. All right, let's turn on our blinky lights. Why is it doing that? I'm not even on this stupid thing. I guess you can't get people out of here yet. Oh, come on. I thought the update allowed you to get people out of here. Lame. All right, he should be good to go. Just fall off. I don't care. Tells Vaos that I did a boo-boo, Vaos. No, I didn't. What you talking about? Double checks and finds one missing. No! Yeah, they use the cloud mods on their Twitter posts. I mean, it's so sad. So when people buy the game, it's almost like false advertising. Repair it. Let's do this. Use your laser. Wait. Has insufficient engineering skill level 1 is required. You're an engineer. Capable of repairing broken parts. There's no skill level. This is sandbox. What? This is... Just checking over some stuff. Kerbals level up immediately, right? All parts upgraded. I'm so confused right now. Aren't repair kits fun? Yeah, they're loads of fun. Use console to spawn Kerbal with sufficient skill. Okay, I think I know what you're talking about. F12, right? Kerbals. Who's he? This guy is Obgas Kerbin. Okay. It's too bad you can't change them right away. Engineer. Experience level 5. Create Kerbal. How does this work, by the way? I hit the create Kerbal button, nothing's really happening. Kerbal created. Okay. Oh, crap. We have to go back to the hangar. Yeah, they don't have any stars by their names. Wow. When was this? I remember having... When Sandbox, you had... Huh, that's not working. That is not working. There they go. Finally. Yay. Wait, they're pilots. Go back. No. I lost my thing. There it goes. Okay. We want engineer. Go. Okay. So go to astronaut complex. Oh shit. I mean darn. Damn it. Create Kerbal. It's like you have to go back and forth almost. It's kind of weird. those. You know what? For the yeah. Oh, gotta go. Have fun. All right, Lone Wolf. See you later. All right, so we got two engineers. And dang it, that's all we're gonna use. I'm done messing around. Okay. Here we go again. Make sure we got everybody. 5-star. Okay, good. Oy, oy, oy. Repair truck. RT1. This is weird. Distractigus, what's up? It's gonna drive me crazy if they're not the right color. Hello, thank you. KSP, why? You were doing so well. Come on. Here we go. If I kill the steering, it won't be so hard. There we go, that's much better. Ah! Oh, gagabinika. Oh! No! 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 Why? No, don't transfer. Oh, screw it. EVA. Ah, darn. It doesn't do the glitch anymore. Okay, we've got a pack. We're gonna do this. Oh, man, that's a long way away. And Viz turtled. Gosh, dang it all to hell. Oh, look here. Oh, look. Give me. Look what we got here. All right. Okay. I think we're okay. Hold on to your butt. Here we go. I have freaking lost it. I'm gone. Oh, stuck. Stop. No! Maybe I should have made the truck a little bit more. You know what? I don't care anymore. go. Just go. I don't care anymore. You have lost my care. There's no more caring for you.
No more caring.
Well, that's why it's all screwed up. There we go. Oh. Take care of this. Go that way. Don't you dare do that again. Why is this sliding to me? What is going on? Brakes? What is going on? Why is that sliding? Okay, it's not sliding anymore. Sort of. The Vaos of Sanity. Yes. Why do I hear boss music? I know. Anime drifting. Forgotten they've got a magnet in their pants. Oh, jeez. Okay, let's try this again. You're an engineer, right? Okay, good. All right. Let's finally do this. Come on. Repair. Oh wow. That was very quick actually. That was lightning quick and there was no gun thing. No gun thing happened. It just kinda happened. Alright, cool. So if you hold down Alt, you get all the stuffs. Sweetness. Got one in the end, okay. Vaos Sanity be like, hello there. Hello, Mindling. How are you? I hope you're doing well. Hit Alt and wait, what? No. Oh, gosh, come on. Go away. Okay, Alt. Yes. All right. Yes. We're gonna fix this. We're gonna fix this bad boy. She'll be ready by the time you. And we don't even know if the SSRT is gonna make it to the ground. I mean, I've tested it many times, but we shall see. Okay, she's fully repaired. Thank goodness. F5. Save. Stonks. Little repair minigame, yeah. Just stare at broken things and make them work. All right, she's repaired. Let's go ahead and oh no, don't crash on me. Thank you. So we're gonna keep this truck over here for now. Okay, let's go ahead and fuel up. It's been a while. Yes, it has. Yeah, I wish I do wish that repairs worked the same way. Only Chuck Norris. Whoa! What? Tokyo Drift? Okay. When this thing is light, it's dangerous. No, 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 don't slide down! No, no, no! Oh, lulu! Why you slide down? Don't slide down! Get back up there. Oh, no. You should see my head just hanging right now. Get up. Come on. Nothing popped yet. I guess that's good news, right? And we're stuck. It's being a real pain in the ass. It's already been 2 hours. We've only got one part up there. Darius nearly goes Tokyo drifting. You done goofed. Try increasing friction control. Yeah, with this. See, most of the weight is on these gears, right? Most of the weight's on the gears. So I have to be very careful with friction control when it comes to that. Because when it gets heavy, oh my gosh. You know what I mean? Okay, let's go ahead and lock this. Alright. Ever so gently. Last time we almost had this thing explode on us. Let's grab some fuel. Are you bouncing? Okay. Hey, you're supposed to have brakes. Why are you doing that? Hello with the brakes. Oh, I see. Your brakes weren't really working. Okay. Okay, okay, we're good. F5? Yes, F5. Trying to enjoy Vaos' ingenuity. Alright, here we go. Bouncing going on. Me no likey. All right, we're fully fueled. Disarm. Back up. And she's fully fueled. All right, we got all the fuel. Ready for another launch. Oh, now she moves real slow. It is now sunset. Do you see the SSL static fire a few days ago? No, I did not. I've been actually very interested in SpaceX more than I have reused shuttle engines. Brakes aren't real. Now, I am trying to hurry this up the best I can. Oh, shh. Wait. The best I can, so when I go to look at chat so I can read, if you have a specific question for me, just go ahead and highlight my name in orange. That way I can zoom in on that particular comment right away. Other than that, you know, I'll be focusing on this game right there. Come on. Just nice and easy. We're just gonna real chillant. Just very nice and easy. No slideys. No Tokyo drifts. Just keep it nice and easy. Spell iCup? Okay, iCup. There, I spelled it for you. Ha ha ha. Ha ha! I spelled it for you. I cup. Now, what I cup, I don't know. That's another question. I could cup a lot of things. Okay, no, no break, no break, no break. Good. We are good. Yowa. Oh, easy. Let's get back out on the runway and then, there you go. Then we'll... Hey, whoa. Oh, no. We're out of electric charge. Huh? When? All right, we're going to have to go through time here. It's going to get dark, but we got to get our charge back. All right, we got a charge back. That's good. Night operation. How long have you been playing KSP? Are you talking to me? Are you talking to me? How does the orange thing work again? Only the streamer sees the orange. I guess at Vaos does it? Alright, we're gonna park it right here. Let's go to Space Plane Hangar. Meanwhile, the scientists up in space, they forget about us? Let's go to Sunrise. Oh, whoa, hey, that was a cool eclipse and you ruined it, KSP. You ruined it. You messed it up. There was an eclipse right there. You messed it up. It was a nice eclipse, too. All right, here's our new launch pad. I can guarantee you that you'll see another. So I ran an idea past my wife. I said, I'll get one of her romance novels and I'll read it. and I'll read it in my radio voice. So I'll be like,
"No."
And he walked into the room. She stared at him, hungry eyes.
That's not even how they read anyway.
I'm just throwing up a thing out. I'm just I can make my own book. I'm good at that.
Yeah, your ad lib just sucked right there.
Read the B movie script? What? She gets very offensive when I talk about her romance novels. Switch to yes. 50 with Vaos with 50 Shades of Grey.
He'll get banned for that.
I would definitely watch that.
Yeah, they're trying to get him banned.
Yes, banned from life. Alright, I think it was that I aim for... Wait. Where's the Kerbal Space Center? Okay, I think it was I aim for the desert up here. Do we have power? Yes, we're good on power. I have to see where the desert is first. I think it's... okay, let's orbit a couple times before we... Aha! That's over here. So we have to kind of bring our apoapsis down to, like, forget. Over across the, gulf. Alright, let me try that. Hit F5, save. Vaos' fanfic. The mouse clicking sounds is enough for me. All right, here we go. In 3, 2, 1. Gauging engines. Engaging engines. Okay, what's going on? Oh, I have to turn them on first. That would That would help. No, no, go away. 70, all right. 60. Let's fast forward a little bit. Trying to make this work. Oh no! The only good romance novel is I'm Gay for My Living Billionaire Jet Plane. Is the jet plane alive or is the billionaire a person? Alright, I'm gonna go for that and hopefully that works. F5 save. Let's do this thing. Make sure we're on our right, in our right mind. Okay, let's go there. And control from here. That means that the nose will be constantly up. Okay, here we go. Preparing landing sequence. It's very, 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 very hard to land exactly right back at the KSP, at the KSC.
At the KFC?
I almost said KFC.
I know.
The jet plane is alive.
I caught that.
It's real, by the way. It's so pretty. Cole Sanders? Oh no, who is that guy? I forgot him. Oh, Colonel Sanders. Get some of my chicken right now. They're finger licking good. By the way, I'm not sponsoring or not being sponsored by KFC. But I would like some. KFC, if you see me right now, just give me a call. Contact me. We can work something out. I can make a bucket of KSC, come from, go to orbit and come back. I could definitely do that for you, for a nice check. Thank you for everyone who's here right now watching. If you could, please, please like the video so that we can fight the YouTube algorithm together. That means so much. That would mean so much to me. Thank you so much. You can call me a sell as much as you want. I'm just trying to remind people that this right here, if they like it, then maybe, you know, they could help me out by clicking the like. More like PooTube video.
It's not what you're saying, Jack. You're saying it. Sounds exactly like Jeremy from the corner.
Cool.
That's not cool.
Awesome. It's awesome. It's great. It's awesome. Vaos is cool. Sanders owns KFC. Yeah. Are we going to land in the ho, hey, 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 hoo ha? We're going to. Hoo ha ha.
Hoo ha ha.
Yeah. Ooh. Ah. Easy. We're not going to land in the KSC. This no good. Oh, crap. We are way too high, going way too fast. Oh, nuts. All right, I'm going to have to pull a maneuver that I told myself I would never do, and we're probably going to die. In 3, 2, 1. Oh, oh, yeah, baby. Oh, the heat. Oh, the heat. Oh, she's slamming it. Oh, she is slamming hard. Oh, she's slamming. Oh, she's slamming. Right into the atmosphere, sky, whatever. Come on. Stop, you big bird. Stop. Oh, you gotta stop. Come on, stop. Come on. You gotta stop for me. Oh, you're going way past where I want you to be. Come on. Come on. Oh, come on. Plane burning. Come on. Oh, we are going way too fast. Now, I put jet engines on this thing in hopes that it would help. Maybe fly it back to fly it back to the Kerbal Space Center if it got too far away, or if it didn't go, you know, the other way like I wanted it to. That's really far away, by the way. Jiminy Christmas. F9, I can't. That's too far away. F9. You can do a dive. Yeah, I know, right? Let's try one more time. I mean, we're close. We're really, 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 really close. So, I'll probably get it on the third try, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to be close enough on the second. Build up speed, might be able to glide back. I mean, she's got jet engines on her, and I put the powerful, what do you call them? What are these? The Panthers on her, and they're in wet mode, so, you know, that's some serious thrust. is like a 60-ton launch vehicle that doesn't have any lift. Well, she's got body lift, right? So I'm hoping that if I was to empty out the engines, like completely empty out and just have the liquid fuel, that'd be light enough to give me some flyability. We all need. All right, here we go again. Let's do this. Breaker, breaker, 1-1. And try some tricks to slow down a little harder. I don't know if it's going to be the smartest thing in the world to do, but it could work. So I'm hitting F right now to try to keep my nose at a higher pitch. As I hit F, the nose goes down, but in very small increments. So if I can keep it around 15 degrees, we're good. Hopefully. Okay, this is when we're going to start braking pretty hard. Going to let my nose stay up. And I'm actually going back up. I see that now. I'm actually going back up. I'm skipping off the atmosphere. You dick. Yeah, come on. Come on. Hard 45 degree angle. Let's go. There you go. Nice and hard. Nice and hard. Ah, my gosh. Maybe I should have gone for a nice hard 45 degree angle to start with. No, there's no way we're going to zoom right by 2,000 meters per second. Good grief, man. All right, third time's got to be the charm. We're just going to go straight up 90 degrees as soon as we get into the atmosphere. Alright, checking apoapsis and periapsis time. Looks good. We're about to get into atmosphere. There we go. Into atmosphere. Degree angle. Hmm. I'm gonna get a real suntan. Keep it at 45 degrees. All right, here she goes. Here she goes. Nice and easy. Oh boy, she's glowing. Easy. Oh crap, we slowed down really hard. Ah, damn, we slowed down way too hard. We're gonna have to point back up. Son of a biscuit, we're going into the Gulf. I think the hardest part, if I remember correctly, the hardest part was actually landing. At the specific spot that I wanted to land at, right? I could feel them slowly dying inside. Yeah, maybe. Sea dragon, maybe. All right, let's do this. Get this set up right, and then do that and go. Keep an eye on it. Keep an eye on it. Alright. Take her off retrograde. Just go on stability assist. Okay, this is not going down as fast as I want. So we're gonna start nosing up. There it goes. Now she's falling pretty fast. She's still falling. All right, we're going to go back to retrograde. Or prograde, excuse me. Here we go. We're just going to keep an eye on it. And we'll give it a little gas here and there if we need to just get it up there. Alright, she's falling into the ocean. Gonna give her a little fuel. Alright, bring her back up. I tried that mod, Mindling, but it doesn't work in 1-1. It's very sad. Just keeping an eye on it. Looks like we're gonna get close. Really, really close. Alright. Give it some gas. Bring that back up. Ooh, easy now. Easy with the heat. Forgot about that. Oh, she's real close to blowing up. Please don't pop. Please. Oh, man. There she goes. Son of a... No, here comes another one. No, just wiggle it out. No! Gosh! Damn it! Two stars. She popped. Are you actually enjoying this project? It just seems like it's making you miserable. There goes the jet engines. We're going in for a landing, damn it. Going in for a landing. Wow, we're actually really low on fuel. Heh. Must have forgot to fuel those bad boys up. I do hope the runway is clear. It's not. It's going to be exploded. Yeah, here we go. Running out of fuel quick. All right. Gears out. Everybody wish me luck. Here we go. All right, bird has touched down. Oh my gosh. The bird has landed. Sweet mama Sita. Oh. Fudge sickles. Shoo. So this time I'm going to just go ahead and build and pop a new one in there. It really is the only way. I'm just going to pop a new one in there. Ah, jeez. Yeah, if I had to learn, everyone else has to, damn it. She's down with a little bruise on her beak. Oh, jeez. What are the random nerd girls doing there? Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to actually recover this. And we'll recover the launch pad as well. And we'll just in space plane hangar, not in space center only. We're going to bring them back. Because really, that took a lot. That took a lot out of me, actually. To be honest, it's 12 o'clock over here. I'm not sure what time it is over there for you guys. But we are definitely not going to finish building the space station today. I think what I'll do is I'll just keep on doing live streams on Saturday morning. Maybe not Saturday mornings. I got something to do next Saturday. But we'll keep on doing live streams until we finish it or something of that nature. Or I will just make a video that's edited together real quick of all the launches and all the load ups and everything and make it 10 minutes long or whatever the case may be. Put some nice music behind it. Do my, you know, famous editing Solar Nations type of stuff. But I think this is going to be close to the end of the stream. But I did want to show you guys something that I'm working on. I'm working on a video right now. But I wanted to show you it before I end the stream. And I think you'll like it. 1700 over there. Ooh, goodness. We're going to actually go. Yeah. Vaos breaks his own rules. Devout the stream believers want anarchy. Vaos, what's your music playlist? Very good. Right now I'm just listening to Nostalgic Drive, which is a synth wave remix thing. And I figured since I have it really low in the background, I'm talking over it. It wouldn't be considered copyright. But if it is, then you know what? well, I'll go ahead and delete this video or something. But anyway, 1700 hours for you too, Mindling? Oh, okay. EDM podcast game, though. Oh, podcasting game. Oh, okay. Well, let's go ahead and I'll show you this one thing that I'm working on. Space Center. I'm making a video about it. It's a build with me kind of video. But I'm actually really excited about it. All right. Good to meet many of you. Yeah, right, Enter. Stop trolling, Enter. Next thing you'll know, you'll be like, what's KSP? Oh, really? How does that work? Resume saved. Okay, so what was it? Default? Yes. I haven't named it yet. I don't believe I have anyway. Or have I? Mindling. Yeah, right, Mindling. I just showed up one day and became mod. Okay, so I'm making a video as we speak. And it took me 2 hours to build this, so don't laugh, damn it. If I see you in my streams many, many, many times, as I saw Mindling in my streams many, 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 many times, then yes, I will make you a mod. Wait a minute. What? No, it's fine. All right, so here it is. Oops, wrong button. Here it is. It is a full-on dump truck. I love it. It's beautiful. And it works just like a real dump truck. I know, because I drive dump trucks. I have a CDL. So you got your pistons that actually push the entire thing up. We have tailgate lock right here. It's a tailgate lock. The tailgate has hinges on it, right? And there's a hinge for the thing right there. It has an engine inside of it and runs off of battery and fuel. Of course, this is kind of like a air horn. And this is, of course, the exhaust pipe. And it's got lights on the top, caution lights. It even has the side light, like a blinker. And it's got lights on the tailgate as well. And yeah, I'm tickled to death. It works, and it comes with its own payload, or not payload. It comes with its own load of stuff. So we're gonna drive it over here and dump it, and then we'll end the stream. But I absolutely am tickled to death about this little creation. Took about 2 hours to make, and right now I'm editing the video. About halfway done. So if you're new to this channel, please like and all that jazz. Super sellout right now. If Coca-Cola is listening, I will sell your product, damn it. Oh, I've never done this before. Let's dump it in the pool. Yes. Yes. Let's dump this crap in the pool. Okay, so you'd back it up. The wheels are all the same. The wheels are just like real life too. You've got your back wheels that are primarily the motor. There's no motor in front. It's all steering. And there's no steering in the back. All right. So I'm going to dump this crap in the pool. Oh, don't go in the pool. All right, there's a little ledge right there. I don't know if you can see that. That's kind of interesting. So once you get up just close enough, you stop, okay? Pull the air brakes. Ooh, we're a little over. That's okay. We're fine. Then you... this is polluting the Kerbal water supply. Go ahead and... So you take your tailgate down. You put your... What you do is you park the truck, pull your air brakes. You turn on your PTO, which engages the hydraulics. You unlock your tailgate, and then you lift up the bed. And all this stuff should just pour right out. There it goes! Oh, that is so awesome. Now, what I do, if it's a real muddy time or a real muddy day or whatever, you don't know if there's a bunch of stuff stuck in there. You're not supposed to do this, by the way, but sometimes I do that. Oh, crap. Pull forward, right? So you pull forward. And then you hit the, and you pull forward and you hit the brakes. Eh. Pull forward, you hit the brakes. Slam the tailgate. And slam tailgate. Should shake all this stuff. You'll see stuff coming out, you know, just little bits and pieces. And of course you bring down, bam, as you hear it going, bam, bam. Right? Of course the lights don't actually attach to the tailgate itself. That's a little blunder on my part. The lights are supposed to be attached to this. I haven't yet gone back and fixed that. Go ahead and lock the tailgate. Turn off your PTO. And then you drive away. That's how a dump truck really works, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that. It's so clean in there now. Okay. Oh, gosh. So, ladies and gentlemen. Or everyone. So when are you going to send it into space? You know what? This could work on another planet. Like on... To be honest, putting a dump truck on the moon, you'd have to change everything, to be honest. It would be very dangerous. Not enough gravity on the moon. It'd be bouncing around and everything. We'd have to put RCS thrusters on everything. To keep it from, like, launching itself into orbit just by driving. That's funny, yeah. Truly impressive, dude. Oh, thank you. So I'm making a video of it so you can kind of build along with me. And in the video, I do make mistakes and we do tests and stuff. So I thought maybe it'd just be easier to just record everything and all, as well as all the mistakes. Because then that gives you an idea of why it can't be done in a certain way. You know what I mean? It'll kind of give you a way of saying, oh, okay, well, obviously he can't do it that way because of this. He was having problems and whatnot. So, everyone, Thank you so much. Oh, thank you. I enjoyed this. Well, thank you. I enjoyed you being here. I am Vaos, everyone. Just keep an eye out for my streams. They will come out. And, yeah. I'm a little tired right now, so my speech pattern's a little off. But I am out of here. Thank you, everyone, for coming. If you liked what you see, please like and subscribe. And I will see you all in the next video or next stream. I am Vaos, signing off, and have a good day. Or night, depends what side of the world you're on. Bye-bye.